Good morning everyone. Welcome to Jam Jodi online classes and also welcome to my science classes. I am Lavanya. Today I will teach you of your science literature chapter number 3. The name of the chapter is your 5 to 5. Okay? Well, so our chapter is 5 to 5. Okay? In your class 7, we have already learned two chapter. Today we discuss about your third chapter, that is your 5 to 5. Okay, dear student. So in this chapter, we must discuss about our racing sense. Okay, many various class like equipment, how they are made, what are the ingredients, how they are prepared. All these types of things were discussed in this video lesson. Okay, dear student. So let's start our discussion. Okay. So dear student, in your daily life, you must wear various different type of clothes. Okay. So such type of things like your party dress.
A bundle of
gather together to form a gear. Okay? So how this gear form? Have you even seen cotton or you know other steel or your wool? These are the various things from where we form this gear like structure, and after some processing it will be converted to gear. And with the help of gear we make different types of cloth. Okay, so that is for your fabric. Fabric are what? Woven materials used for making cloth. Okay, so here are woven together just as material. These are the thread. Okay, when they are woven, they are crushed with one another and form a piece of cloth sheet. Okay, this is called your woven process. Okay, so when your yarn are woven together and form and used for form cloths that are for your fabric. Okay, so here we know about what is fiber and what are fabric. Now discuss here in this class what the fiber are made of two types. One is your natural fiber and another is your synthetic fiber. Okay, your fiber are of two types. One is natural and another synthetic. Okay. In class 8 we will learn about synthetic fiber. Here in class 7 we only learn about the natural fibers. The natural fibers are also two types that are obtained from plant sources and another is obtained from your animal sources. Okay, so the sources from where the sources of animal from we obtain the natural fiber that are the animals are your silk and also the various wool for you. Okay, so these are the two fiber that we obtain from animals, and the plant product are your cotton. These are the product from plant we obtain fiber. So here we know that fiber are of two types, that are natural fiber and synthetic fiber. Here we don't discuss about the synthetic fiber. In this video lesson, we only discuss about the natural fiber. Okay? The natural fiber are which fiber? Those are obtained in nature. Okay? So natural fiber are also two sources that are plant sources and animal sources. So in this class we also left the plant part, plant fiber. We only discussed on animal fiber. Okay. So the two main sources of animal fiber, that is your silk and wool. So in this video lesson we only discussed about the how wool are formed, when they grow, what are the processing to form a wool, and how silk are formed, what are the your development of silk, the life process of silk, all these things were discussed in this class. Okay, so let's start from wool. Okay, so here the hair of animals like silk and yarn from which wool is obtained. You have observed that the hair that is found in very hilly area and also some silk, they possess
of animals like sea, deer, llama, camel, and very recently angora goat. From the layer of this type of animals are called as fleas. Okay? So now discuss the various characteristics of wool. Okay? We must wear the cloth which is made of wool. Okay? So the wool fabrics are mainly used for your winter clothes. Okay? So that way we wear at the season of winter to protect us from the cold. Okay? So what are the characteristics of wool? That is, it does not wrinkle easily. So what is wrinkle? Wrinkle means our cotton clothes that is there is seriously squeeze quite good. Okay? But in the case of wool, in the case of the cloth that is made of wool, that cannot be easily wrinkled. That is always in the straight form. Okay? After that, it has a natural resistance to dirt. Okay? So the cloth is that is made of wool that cannot be easily dirty. So it has a natural property to resistance from the dirt. Okay? After that, it's clasp and retain air that becomes it to a very conductor of heat.
Alpaca, bread. Sip is for your bread. Okay? So, in our India, approximately 200 types of wool are obtained from 40 different types of silk. Okay? So, there is question here. So, there are 14 different types of silk. Okay? But out of 14 different types of silk, we obtain 200 different types of wool. How this can be possible? Okay? So, this can be possible to get because we choose selective breeding. Okay? So what is selective breeding? Selective breeding are the technology from where we obtain such a special quality of wool from a different your seed. Okay? So this can be done from cross breeding. Okay? So what is cross breeding? Cross breeding is an artificial process of mating of a different kind of male and different kind of female. So the this is a process where we artificially meet them and we collect the required our required property of the wool. Suppose A is a type of seed where the resistance to a disease is high, but here B is a type of seed that produce very good quality of wool. So we have to mate them and prepare a different type of seed. So in this seed, both the property of A and B are there. So this process is called the crossbreeding. So in this process, we artificially mate different kind of seed to get the such a different and better quality of seed. Okay? So by the process of crossbreeding, we are able to create very useful and our required very good quality of wool. Okay? So these are the discussion about your seed rearing and breeding. Now today let's discuss how the extraction of wool are being done. So here we learn about extraction of wool. There are the different steps. The extraction of wool cannot be done in a single step. It requires many more steps. Here I read that. After that, I will discuss everyone. So, it complete. Okay. So, these are the steps that can be followed to extract wool from hair of this animal. So, some steps are like searing, scalding, grading, washing, then carding, then spinning, then dyeing, then your final processing. So, dear student, now let's discuss everything in a brief manner. Okay, so what is searing, what is called your scalding? So, what kind of the process are done, how they can be prepared, let's discuss it.
Okay,
so this die. So the sharing process is mainly done at the summer season. Okay. So at this process there is no harm. There is no harm or no pain we feel by the usage, because when we cut our hair, and also we don't feel any type of pain. And when we cut, at the same way, there is no collection of nerve tissue with the hair of this hair of the sheep. So we can easily remove it, and no pain or no problem. So we no trouble to feel while you feel by the sheep. Okay. Sharing is done at the season of summer. After that, the next shape is your scoring. Okay? Scoring your person. Okay? So, what is scoring? So, the wrinkles, the skin that will be removed from the body surface of the sheep, that may contain various dots and various different types of immunity are there. So, these people are obtaining a smooth and good quality of wool.
All the wool, and after the process of carding, all wool
Even, mad, they will be go for prepare yarn that will be used for oven. These are all the for all the discussion about the extraction of wood. Okay? So dear student, in this class we learn about this. So in the summary, we learn about all about the fiber and also the fabric. Okay? So in this also various wool cleaning.